This video is about the multiplier effect and how it applies to markets in emergencies. We're not going to go into the detailed economics behind multiplier effects or explain the graphs and formulae, but we will try and put it in context. What are multiplier effects in a humanitarian market setting? And how can this help us make decisions about how we program? All around the world, people depend on markets for their lives and livelihoods. And in an emergency, many humanitarian organisations now choose to work with the local market system to deliver aid. Where markets are functioning, we can give cash or vouchers to beneficiaries and work to strengthen markets in an affected area. And this approach can be better than bypassing the system, bringing in your own supplies from outside. But why is this? One reason is to do with the multiplier effect. Imagine an affected area where the market is functioning after a crisis. Your agency gives targeted beneficiaries a cash transfer of $50 to help them recover from the crisis and replace what they've lost. Let's imagine one of those families sits together and decides how to spend the money. They decide to spend $20 on food, including rice, meat, and vegetables, spend $10 on medicine for their daughter. They spend $15 on household items like soap, toothpaste, and cooking pots, which they lost in the emergency, leaving them $5, which they decide to save for now. That day, they go to market and buy what they need. The family spend their $15 for their household items with a local trader in the market. End of story, right? But what happens to that money when they spend it? The money doesn't disappear. The trader gets $15 income, and she, in turn, decides how she'll spend it. Because so many people are coming to her to replace their household goods, she decides to employ another person to help her from within the community. And she buys more supplies, some of which are made locally in the same affected area. And with the remaining money, she buys food for her own family from the market. The new person she employs now has money coming in, and he, in turn, decides how to spend it. He buys some food for his family, a new pair of shoes made locally, and with the remaining money, he buys some credit for his mobile phone from the phone shack in the market, which generates income for three more traders, who, in turn, decide how to spend it, and so it continues. Each time the money is spent, it generates more economic activity in the market. It has a knock-on effect to more people within the economic area. And let's remember, beneficiaries and traders aren't two different groups. In many communities, beneficiaries are also trading, working and benefiting from the economic activity in their area. It sounds small, but let's imagine 1,000 beneficiary families all receive a cash transfer of $50. They spend it in the local markets, generating more and more economic activity, more spending, and more employment. So that $50 cash grant could generate five or more cycles of activity and end up contributing much more than the original $50 worth in economic growth. Multiply this across tens of thousands of beneficiaries, and you can soon see how a small amount of cash translates to a much larger value for local communities. This is called the multiplier effect, as the original amount has been multiplied to create even more value. It's worth remembering that not all markets are functioning after a crisis, and it's important that we know our local markets, monitor while we're delivering, and be agile enough to switch back to delivering with our own supply chains if the market takes a turn for the worse. But where markets are functioning, investing in the economic area connected to beneficiaries can have a greater multiplied impact.